Michael and Aaron have basically been using medical assistance since birth. They were born 3 months premature, spent 6 months in the hospital. They were at a month old, they were called the million-dollar babies, and if we didn't have medical assistance right off the start, I don't know what we would have done. Of course, I have no list, and I feel bad for going after such a...
Oh, I speak on behalf of all of us.
List isn't required.
No, I just, about 2 weeks ago, there was a conversation about possibly losing medical assistance just because, unfortunately, my father-in-law passed away, and there was inheritance and everything like that. I cried. I literally cried because it's not just one child that I have. I have two kids with medical assistance. We do what we can, and we make improvisations, and we don't have a hospital bed at home. It's not something that we need, but they need to be safe. So we bought the kid bed rails. Michael has a motorized wheelchair along with his regular wheelchair. And he just got this one last year, and that was over $28,000. And our primary health insurance only pays 20%. And after that 20%, you have to pay the rest. Michael also, both of them, before I keep going on about medical, Aaron was born and had bleeding in his brain, which caused the ventricles to enlarge, and he has two shunts put in, which causes seizures, and he has autism, and he has ADHD. Michael had cysts, which was called periventricular leukomalacia, such a big word for such an impact on his life. They both have cerebral palsy. Aaron's affected on his right side, where Michael is, his legs are affected, and his arms struggle less than his legs, but he doesn't walk without arm canes, which he's trying really hard to do. It's a struggle for him. If we didn't have medical assistance, we wouldn't have arm canes, we wouldn't have wheelchairs, we wouldn't have medicine, doctor's appointments. I mean, Michael goes to physical therapy on top of school therapy at Shriver's, and he goes once a week for additional support for land therapy, and he just started aquatic therapy to help his mobility. Medical assistance pays for that. If they didn't, it was $150 per visit. It's amazing what medical assistance does for our family, because like I tell everybody, if we didn't have it, we'd live in a box. We would be on the street because our kids would have everything they possibly could need, and they come first. And to have that possibility of losing more than what we fight for every day is, I don't know. I can't get over how effective it is for us. I mean, we're spending, you look at the pharmacy list, and you're spending $3,000 just for one boy a month, and think, well, our insurance, our primary insurance is decent. My husband works for the township. I mean, I'm not gonna complain. It could be a lot worse, but everything is 20%. We have our deductibles, we have our co-pays, and stuff for the boys, it's covered. And not having that times two, leg braces, they get them at least once a year, goes as they grow, like you said. And the last ones, Michael's, cost $3,600. So, I mean, I just look at all that and think, Michael started swallow therapy when he was 6 months, 8 months old. He ended up going back into the hospital and had tracheomalacia, which in turn made him have a tracheotomy. And he had that for about 2 years, but that stunned all of his growth and his vocal cords and the swallowing and everything like that. Well, now he's 12 and needs to start swallow therapy. Our primary insurance pays it, but Gateway finds it non-medically necessary. So, even though they find it not medically necessary, we're still paying that copay of $50 every time he goes. He needs it. We have to pay for it. It's not negotiable. I'm just trying to think of...
Oh, fuck!
Just trying to think of, like, other things that... I mean, we try to do what we can, but without medical assistance, I just don't know what I do. I mean, Aaron goes to a doctor over in Lancaster for his autism and his different mood swings and medications. We're trying and they pay for it, even though we're trying different things. I mean, we try over-the-counter medicine that we're paying for, but those little things that we don't, they take care of. And just at the impact that it's had on our lives for the past 12 and a half years, I don't know what I would do. I mean, and helping fund our schools to get what our kids need and deserve. They didn't ask for this life. They didn't ask to be handicapped, but to take something away that you could possibly keep on to help their needs, I don't see what the reason would be.
Well, testimony that we don't hear enough of in Washington. It's, your presence here and your own testimony is part of the way we make the case, because we're in a real debate. This is a fundamental debate, I think, about what kind of country we're going to be at its core. And I'll say more later, but I'm grateful you're willing to take a time out of your day to be here with us. Because your testimony, your witness, in a sense, gives us a shot at winning this argument. But it's still weeks ahead of more debate and more work. So thanks for taking all the time and bringing your boys here.
Thank you.
And they're both, what, their age is?
They're 12.
12 now, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.